Hey everyone, Daniel here from Twin Bytes with another quick tutorial for you. This time I was asked by Logan Plays about how to add programs to the system tray in Windows 10. Now, although you can't add programs, shortcuts to the system tray, there are programs out there that allow you to minimize your open programs to a system tray. But I don't like dealing with the third-party software like that if we don't need to try and do something that Windows isn't meant to do. But if you want to add programs to the start menu, not just minimize something that's open, but have shortcuts to them there, you can't add them to the system tray, but I'm going to show you how you can create a little menu folder right beside the system tray that'll have a bunch of small icons right there for you. So the first thing we want to do is create a couple of folders. I'm going to call one Programs, and I'm going to create one for Browsers. So you can have multiple folders and get these set up in advance. Now what I want to do is down, right click on the taskbar, go to Tools and New Toolbar. And this is where we can go to browse to where we created the folders. I'll select Browsers here and then select Folder, and you can see Browsers appeared here. Now, when you want to add the shortcuts to them, there's two ways of doing it, but to add the first one, we have to go to the folder where it was stored, where we created it, and I'll grab a browser and drag it over there so we got the shortcut to Edge. So if I look at Browsers here, there's a double arrow right beside it. If I click that, there's Edge. So I've got two different ways of adding to that now. The easy way is to just grab it and drag that into the folder here, but if I don't want to open that, I can drag it here, but it's very particular. You can't just drag it on top of the name because it just doesn't seem to want to refresh that. It's very, very picky, where you have to be right on the double arrow, and it's kind of hard to see that when the big icon is covering it. It's not a huge deal to set this up. You're not going to be in there all the time. Is just grab your icons, and it can be from anywhere, even if it's in your full start menu. And we'll just find Chrome over here and drag it so you can see it doesn't have to be right out of this section of the start menu. It can be anywhere over here. And grab all your icons, and when we look at the bottom, there they are. So you can have multiple taskbars. If we go to Toolbars and create a new toolbar again, this time we'll go into the Programs folder that I created. And we'll open that folder. There's nothing in there currently. So we'll start adding some programs. Maybe I want a couple of my popular ones, maybe Outlook, maybe QuickBooks, and we'll add one more. Maybe we want to have Netflix in there. So we got a few programs there, and here now it's more clearly identified that there's the arrows beside Browsers and there's arrows beside Programs, and whichever one you click on, you can't click on the name again, it has to be on the arrows, then you're able to access all those shortcuts. Now it's very easy to just right click on any one of these things and delete them out of that list. And I almost forgot to show you how easy it is to get rid of these things. If you don't want to have these anymore or any one of them, just right click again on the taskbar where there's nothing. Go up to Toolbars and you'll see that they have check marks beside them. So if I check off Programs, you can see the Programs one disappeared. I'll right click, go up to Toolbars, you'll see Programs does not exist here at all anymore. And you can go to New Toolbar, Programs is there, you can select that, and Programs is back again. And that's really all it is to just adding shortcuts to the system tray. And even though they're not in the system tray per se, it's right beside it and they're very small, the same size as what you would have had if they were in the system tray. And in my opinion, this is even better because you can organize them as I have, where you can identify the type of programs and categories, saying Browsers, Programs, Apps, games, whatever you want to classify them as, you can set them up that way and have as many toolbars as you want and turn them on and off anytime. That's it for this tutorial. I hope you did find it helpful, and if you did, please do hit that like button, consider subscribing, and ring the bell to be notified every time I come out with a new video. Thanks so much. We'll see you in the next one. Bye for now. Yoink. And then let's do it. Let's do this. Let's try again. That's a pain in the ass. There's nothing.